Dear Srila Prabhupada, please accept my humble obeisances at the lotus feet. On this auspicious appearance day of yours, I want to follow the path of devotional service with determination and also ask for your mercy. You are so merciful to this fallen soul that though I keep committing mistakes, you with love keep forgiving them. Your merciful glances keeps me fixed in devotional service. Thus your mercy cannot be described in words. By having your darshan, I have made my life successful. I request that you please keep me at the dust of your lotus feet. Your servant, Chitraketu Das, Nairobi. Hare Krishna. Now I'll make my offering, and I'll begin by telling you a story. This last Sunday, I was at the farm and we had two Muslim guests. And these two Muslim guests were arguing with each other whether Krishna is God. And one of them was saying, Krishna is not God, because I have watched in movies that in the movie they show that Krishna took an ordinary bath. Then the other Muslim was telling this one, no, Krishna did not take an ordinary bath. Whatever they show in the movies, that is not the correct one. Then she went on to describe the whole story of Krishna's birth. Then I was thinking, how powerful is this Krishna consciousness movement? That because Srila Prabhupada has written his books, and in these books, Srila Prabhupada has explained systematically how Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead. That we can have two Muslims, they are arguing with each other, and one of them is convincing the other, using knowledge from Srila Prabhupada's books, how Krishna is indeed the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Then I could understand that Srila Prabhupada is the perfect master. So on this day of the appearance day of Srila Prabhupada, my prayer to Srila Prabhupada is that I may be able to read his books more and to hear his lectures more. Srila Prabhupada ki.